Good morning, students. Today we shall go with the poem The Daffodils, written by William Wordsworth. So many of you have heard about this beautiful poem, and William Wordsworth, being a romantic poet, he has a special attachment to nature, compares nature to a thing of extraordinary beauty, and therefore often finds in nature a kind of solace to his otherwise pensive self. For Wordsworth, nature has the power in it to provide human beings not only a visual treat, but also joy to the mind and peace to the soul. In this poem, The Daffodils, the poet talks about how a look at the daffodils makes the poet fly like a cloud and soar higher and higher in pleasure. Moreover, the poet points out how when he is in a foul mood, is in a very pensive mood, how he finds pleasure in thoughts of daffodils. For a poet like him who is in love with nature, daffodils are the happiest company. Here in the poem you will find jocund company and the greatest inspiration. The poem Daffodils deals with Wordsworth finding daffodils to be a thing of extraordinary beauty, and how the poet is exalted in just having a look at the daffodils. So students, we shall go line by line, so stanza by stanza. So we shall start with stanza 1. I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high o'er vales and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils, beside the lake beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze. Here the poet has been referred as I. Okay, so from the background of the poem, we can deduct that the poet was wandering near a lake at Gratsmere in England, and he is walking lonely, he is alone. He moves around alone as a cloud. Okay, he compares his moving around as lonely as a cloud, and crosses over the hills and valleys when he sees. It's while he was walking alone, he sees a multitude of daffodils blooming together beside the lake. The breeze on the daffodils is making them flicker and dance. The poet finds the scene to be a thing of extraordinary beauty. Now, wandered meaning roaming or to move around. Here you will find while wandering, what does he encounter? He encountered a large number of golden daffodils. Where are they? They are beside a lake and beneath the trees. The poet refers to daffodils as golden to symbolize the magical effect it creates in the heart and mind of the poet. And here the lines personify the beautiful daffodils. Okay, the personification is found. Okay, the lines here personify the beautiful daffodils. The poet sees the daffodils growing along the margin of a bay, and they appear to be dancing and fluttering in the breeze. These lines are important, as it was the daffodils' lively appearance that captivated the poet. Okay, we also find he using the figure of speech hyperbole. Okay, the poet saw a huge cluster of daffodils along the riverside, which can be deducted from the words crowd and host. Moreover, in a hyperbolic expression, the poet later said, 10,000 I saw at a glance. So hyperbolic expression of the words are found in this first stanza. Now coming to the second stanza. Continuous as the stars that shine and twinkle on the Milky Way, they stretched in never-ending line along the margin of a bay. 10,000 so eye at once, at a glance, tossing their heads in sprightly dance. Now, what do you mean by Milky Way, children? Milky Way is the galaxy which contains our solar system and contains about 100 or to 400 millions of stars. Okay, so he compares the number of daffodils to the Milky Way. Never-ending line. He says infinite. Never-ending line means infinite. And you know the margin of bay? It's a water body connected to an ocean which is formed by an indentation of the shoreline. And so he compares the crowd of daffodils to that of the Milky Way. Okay, the poet says that the daffodils are blooming in such a numbers, okay, such a great number that they seem to be never ending like the stars and the Milky Way. Along the bay line, the poet in a glance can see more than 10,000 daffodils dancing with the blowing breeze. He says, 10,000 saw I at a glance, tossing their heads in sprightly dance. So the poet uses exaggeration to emphasize the large number of daffodils that he saw during his walk along the river. The exaggeration of daffodils is stretched endlessly in a river-ending line along the margin of a bay is beautiful. The use of such exaggeration thus heightens the poetic effect. And the Milky Way is the galaxy. It contains the solar system, isn't it? So it is referred to in the extract to draw out a comparison between a crowd of beautiful daffodils, beautiful golden daffodils, indistinguishable from each other, and a continuous band of twinkling stars in the night sky. So beautiful comparison, okay? The number of the crowd of daffodils to that of the limitless stars. Now coming to the third stanza, you find the waves beside them danced, but they outdid the sparkling waves in glee. A poet could not but be gay in such a jocund company. I gazed and gazed, but little thought what wealth the show to me had brought. And so here the poet notices the gentle breeze blowing over the dancing daffodils, creating patterns of waves to them, which is better than the beauty of the glowing waves of the seawater. And the sight of the waves of dancing daffodils makes the poet so joyous that he states that there is nothing in this world which can make the poet so happy as the beauty of the dancing daffodils. So he uses the word jocund company. He felt himself be in a happy company, jocund, in such a jocund company. As the poet carries on gazing at the daffodils and thinks about the wealth he gains at the sight of the daffodils. I gazed and gazed, but little thought what wealth the show to me had brought. Now he says the wealth was brought to the poet when he encountered the golden daffodils surpassing the beauty of dancing waves. Wealth here refers to the peace and happiness that the show of daffodils fluttering and dancing before him brought to him. Okay, the wealth here is peace and happiness that the daffodils brought into the life of, into the pensive mood of the poet. The vast belt of daffodils tossing their heads in sprightly dance captivates him. The daffodils even outdo the waves in glee. What is outdoing the waves? The daffodils. This golden company makes the poet feel happy and one with nature. The poet is happy and cheerful in the mood. He says, a poet could not but be gay in such a jocund company. This feeling of oneness with nature that the poet has experienced on seeing lively and dancing daffodils is the reason for his happy mood, the jocund company. Now coming to the fourth stanza, For oft, when on my couch I lie, in vacant or in pensive mood, they flash upon that inward eye, which is the bliss of solitude, and then my heart with the pleasure fills and dances with the daffodils. Now what does he says? He states that very often he becomes sad, or his thought process goes vacant. He becomes so very blank, so aloof, so very pensive. Okay, pensive means sad, and the solitude when he is in his own, and he feels himself very lonely, then this thought of daffodils bring him joy. Whenever he comes to such a foul mood, the sight of the dancing daffodils beside the glowing waves of the lake water makes the poet forget his vacant thoughts and sad mood to get a certain happiness of solitude, which fills the poet's heart with a pleasurable thought. And when he lies down on his couch in pensive mood, the images of those golden daffodils flash before him and change his mood into a happy one. He uses the word bliss of solitude. What does it refers to? This bliss of solitude is referred to the paradise. The poet finds himself in, as soon as the image of golden daffodils flashes before his eyes, his loneliness is overtaken by the images of daffodils, which makes him feel as if he were dancing along with the daffodils. So, here for him, for Wordsworth, nature becomes a positive force for him. When the poet lies on his couch in a contemplating mood, the image of dancing daffodils flashes before him, it appears before him. He is filled with happiness. Thus, the very thought of being in the lap of nature uplifts his spirit. And so, we conclude the lesson of the beautiful poem, The Daffodils, by stating that nature is always a provider. Okay, he mentions how daffodils is the most jocund company of the poet, and how his pensive self transformed to gay state when he is reminded of the daffodils. The poem deals with the extraordinary beauty of daffodils, and the poet's response to the existence or thought of daffodils is very befitting to the title of the poem. So, dear students, go through line by line, try to understand the feeling of the poet while seeing the golden daffodils in great number. Imagine how you could feel when you walk near a lake filled with beautiful lilies or the daffodils, and how does it create what kind of feelings you receive while walking through the nature. Compare your feeling with that of the Wordsworth, and then feel nature is the giver of all happiness, peace and joy. So all the best students, go through the poem once again, read it. I'll get back to you to help you with answering the reference to context.